Jordan me. Woke up.
Like I'm late to it. Got so much drive, I need brake fluid. Don't do it like the bay do it. Sheesh. I'ma get the trying. Sheesh. You ain't got a boy, you lying. Sheesh. DB. Around in the lab like I'm DD. Me and my pops built this like wood shop. The brakes went out, I wish I could stop. I ain't no mechanic, but I made the hood pop. Came from the bottom, I need. We been.
Is the game working? Or is the stream working? Yeah, it's kind of popping up for me.
For the visiting team, at shooting guard, Malachi Brown. At small forward, Richmond. At the other forward position, number 7,
all right, let's ride. Bet is good. Iowa, the 20-7 Iowa team is going up against the struggling Syracuse Orange.
Just 2 games before the playoffs get going.
The number 1 center in the nation, Jamal Rush, going up against the number 2. Center in the nation, Dylan Owens, the dominant paint beast, the white Shaquille O'Neal, if you must. The blonde-haired big man, 6'11" Owens versus the 6'10" Jamal Rush. It should be a center-dominant matchup as Owens does get the ball.
Here's Owens.
Owens goes into the paint. Kicks it out to Licata. Clock
at 6.
Gives it back to Owens in the paint. Gets double teamed off rip. Owens has decent passing, but ooh, good shot made, and Iowa will take the lead 3-0. Now Dawes, the second best player on the Syracuse team, gives it to Rush. Rush drives in, tough shot is no good as Owens gets the rebound. Now it's back to Licata. This is the first look of this Iowa team. Mainly dominated by the center as Hutchinson misses the wide open 3.
Out to the right wing.
Both teams you are seeing are both dominated by their centers as another miss for Syracuse and another rebound for Owens. Back to Licata, now Bowen. A screen open again. Hutchinson for 3. No good. Tough shots, and now it's Rush. You'll see a lot of that. Rush is very good at dribbling as he's wide open in the paint. Dunk for Rush over Owens. Owens is more of a traditional big man, while Jamal Rush is a do-it-all big, can score from any area and defend any position. And now it is Iowa back with the ball. Owens doesn't see as many touches as Jamal Rush, mainly because this Iowa team is better than Syracuse, as there is a miss for Owens over Rush. Now it's Dawes with the ball, the second best player of the Syracuse team. Gives it to Rush for 3, and it's good. Showing off why he has number 1 pick potential in this year's draft. And now Licata with the ball. Screen by Owens. It looks like right now, it's only the first quarter, but looks like Owens is losing this battle. Look at that. He has a wide open mid range. He's being tested and he's not shooting it. Good pass though. And it is a good 3 as well as they take the lead as they have 2 3-pointers.
Yeah, I love the
competitive fire right there. Out of everything, probably a rare advantage Owens has over Rush is his passing and his in the paint ability. But besides that, it's not really any advantage. Maybe shot IQ and overall game IQ. But besides that, Jamal Rush does seem like the superior. And rebounding as well. Rebounding. Owens is a better rebounder. Everything in the paint is better. As a rebound over Rush. Ooh, bad shot, but it does still connect with the receiver. And now off the ball screen. Another possession due to Owens. Offense rebounds. A half court heave. And it nearly goes in. Wow. Rolls in and out. I've never seen that. Off the backboard. Now it's Dawes who gets a screen. And more screens by Syracuse will receive or will end up with Brown with the ball.
Now here's Brown. Tightly guarded.
Rush screen. And he gets the ball for three over Owens. Oh, what a shot! Right over the big man. Jamal Rush is definitely winning this battle right now. Look at that. Right over his head with barely any shot on any time on the shot clock. Definitely Jamal Rush is winning this battle so far.
Here's Bowen. Still no points.
And potentially he could be the number one pick. It's most likely going to be Rocky Michael M, unless he's going to be a shock player. But the most realistic is Jamal Rush and Rocky Michael M as potential number one pick candidates as another three for Iowa. And now they're only down by one. Only a couple seconds left. Jamal Rush from half court. Almost made the half court heave in and out. And it's going to be a 1-point lead for Syracuse, who has a much worse record than Iowa. 20-7 Iowa versus 9-17 Syracuse.
Game through the first quarter. And what do you guys think about the visitors here in this one?
It's simple. The main takeaway from the first quarter is
now
it's
going to be Dawes dribbling the ball. Owens is still in the game, but Jamal Rush is subbed out. And he's able to do that because he just doesn't get the ball as much. Jamal Rush gets the ball all the time, so he needs a break. But Owens can stay in the game for much longer as he gets another rebound. He is dominating the board so far. And now Sanford dribbles in with a smaller Dawes on him, and he makes the shot up by two. Is Iowa. Now Dawes with the ball, gives a good pass. And man, that man is having himself a day. I think he's made two threes now, and he just got an and one dunk over Owens. And he misses the free throw. Another rebound for Owens. If you took the over on the Owens rebound, you are doing very well tonight. And now it's McCaffrey gets a screen. Gives it to Owens still. Owens top of the key again. He can actually hit the middle range, but he is not going to be too kind on shooting it. And Iowa, another three-pointer made, and they take a lead. And now it's going to be Dawes dribbling up. Gives it to Beck. Back to Dawes. Back to... I don't know how to pronounce his name, to be honest, but that man is playing amazing. My goodness. And now it's going to be McCaffrey. You know he's a shooter. In and out, though. And now again, number zero. I'm just going to say number zero. Number zero. Gives the ball up, and it's going to be another rebound for Owens. I mean, that's not boosting his stock too high, but it's just showing how good of a rebound he is. Because most people, they usually don't get more than three assists tonight. Or in a single game you watch, they don't get more than like three or four rebounds. He already has like six.
I mean, they'd want him to take that again.
Dawes with the ball.
Again, those are the shots you want him to take.
And number zero again nearly makes the shot.
He expects to make every one of those, and we expect him to make them.
Now it's going to be Sanford screen by Owens, who is still in the game, surprisingly. Iowa tries another three, though. No good.
Maybe he was too wide open.
Now it's going to be Dawes with the ball. Gives it up And again, number zero, Jamal Rush is about to be subbed in the game, but number zero with the ball, he's getting clamped, getting bodied in the paint. And oh, he somehow gets open, but he misses the layup. And now it's going to be Samford with the ball. Owens has not really gotten the ball, even with a backup center on him. And as I say that, he gets the ball, fade away. Yeah, they are doubling Owens, making sure he doesn't make the ball. And it's going to be a miss for Iowa.
If he gets that look again, he should take it. You can't let one miss scare you off of a very good shot.
Now it's going to be, again, number zero with the ball, with Owens on him.
46 seconds left in the second quarter.
And it's going to be Harris with the ball.
The three is up.
Again, number zero. That was a huge check type of shot. That shot alone could have just upped his draft stock. Harding gives the ball to McCaffrey. Now Owens. And he gets his little spin. Bad shot. He had a lane. And he didn't really take it.
Yeah, you don't have to be quick. You just have to be deliberate.
And now is number zero holding for the last shot. Jamal Rush has not played this entire quarter.
Harris outside. Three-pointer.
And no good, and that is a half. One-point game is still a lead for Syracuse, even though Jamal Rush didn't play a single second of action.
Well, Jason, you hold the lead going into halftime. What's been your advantage so far?
For most of the half, we were really good.
Appreciate it, Allie. And we'll be coming right back after this break, ready for the third quarter.
How they've come in here and taken charge. Hostile crowd, but these guys are blocking out the noise.
Yeah, they came and prepared for this, and the results have been outstanding.
Okay, now we've got some time to take a look at the Eastern Conference standings as the postseason comes into view.
You take a look at the visitors. They haven't played their best ball, it's an understatement. Looking a little lost and flustered right now. It's almost like they don't have any confidence in themselves.
And that's it for halftime. Thank you for joining us. We send you back to Brian Anderson for the start of the third quarter.
Let's give a round of applause. And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. Shooting 40% from the field in this one.
All right.
Pass to Rush.
Rush with the ball. He is back. Fade away immediately. Hook is no good.
Shooting around 33%. Not the
and
best
now it's
going to
be
efficiency.
Bowen with the ball. Bro got dunked on. Owens is better than Zay. Most rankings would have that, but again, someone like Kyron Matthew was projected 13th, and he went number one, and he actually turned out being probably the best player in the draft, considering the fact that Ayuk ended up being hurt. But Ayuk was the considered number one consensus, so not really surprising that he is the second best player with the injury. If you didn't get injured, honestly, he's probably going to make the All-Star team. Does Owen have 0 points? I mean, I know he has 7 rebounds. I think he has like 7. Did Owen finally get subbed out? I think he might have. No, he is still in. He has not got subbed out 1 second of action as they give it to Owens. He gets double teamed. They are making sure he's not getting open for too long, at least. And Iowa still has the lead, though. Beating Jamal Rush will definitely boost his draft stock, as that may not help Syracuse.
He gives you everything you want and need in that wing position.
Now it's Hutchinson with the ball.
And we're just about a minute.
I would like to see Owens get a screen. He's not the type of pick and roll center, but at least get him involved in that way. As Lakeda hits a three, maybe they don't need to get him involved. He's just being a pinned down screener, and it's working as they keep hitting threes. And now Jamal Rush moving around, but they give it to Richmond in the paint, and he is an easy layup.
Richmond's gotten his second bucket of the game.
Both teams are not shooting too good from the field.
They wanted to make sure of that possession.
But Syracuse is actually doing better, but because of Iowa's three, they are winning. Now Owens with the ball. Ooh, yeah, fadeaway is not the shot you want. Now it's going to be Lakeda, a good shooter. Will get a screen by Owens, but he's in jail. He has to just shoot up a shot. It's a bad shot.
Shooting around 41%.
If I was Syracuse, though, you got to give the ball to Dawes and maybe a little pick and roll action with Owens. He's not fast. I'll definitely say that. Jamal Rush is very athletic, but Owens is not. Rush is moving around the. Whoa, jacks up a three. No good. Bad shot again. Owens. There is no way he just, or no reason he should have got that rebound. He just, he has a knack for the ball. As Owens is wide open. Oh, what is he doing? He had that. That was way too long to throw that pass in general. Hutchinson for three. 5-point game for Iowa as Syracuse is choking the game. And Jamal Rush is doing absolutely nothing for his team. I would honestly say Owens is winning this matchup as Jamal Rush hasn't done nothing since the first quarter, and Owens is at least getting rebounds, and his team is winning.
Racking up the blocks and really setting the tone. Gone just one of three in the second half.
Sometimes you don't need to score to be impactful, as I think, yep, he finally got subbed out. But so did Jamal Rush as they hit a very tough three. I don't know why they subbed out Rush. At this point, he's not even playing a lot of minutes at all.
Here's Bowen, defended by Brown.
But Lakeda now for a mid-range and it's way too easy. This Iowa team can shoot the lights out. You cannot leave them open like that.
But since the break, they've really managed to improve in that area.
And now to Beck with the ball. Goes for three. It's no good.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him.
Now Hutchinson dribbles up the court with a little bit of time left in the third quarter. Lakeda gives it to Bowen. Pretty much everyone's Iowa team can shoot threes. Pretty much everyone besides Owens, actually. Lakeda, way too easy. And that's going to be an and one. And honestly,
plays like that right there are what help create easy scoring opportunities.
Oh, missed free throw though. This would be big if Syracuse is able to score here. As they get fouled and they will stop the clock with 4 seconds left.
First team foul.
And now Owens is in the game now.
Number 24.
And no Rush. She is playing so much more minutes than Rush. Ooh, number zero in the corner.
One on the clock.
Mid-range is no good. And Owens nearly just had another
one. They lead by six.
He's projected around 5-6. As Aiden Anthony is projected about 3-5. But again, Tyron Matthews, there's always that big jump. Maybe not, you know, that high of a jump to the number one pick, but usually there is a big jump inside the top five. As Owens sets a screen, McCaffrey for three is no good.
It's a blow to a team that was hoping to be healthy coming down the stretch.
And now number zero with the ball.
Okay, thanks for the update.
Gives it to Dawes.
Now we know how things are coming along.
Even though we don't say his name, number zero has made himself a name. As Dawes, who had been very quiet tonight, usually the second best player. As he goes into the lane, nice shot, and nice move, and they call a timeout. If you're Syracuse, you have to keep number zero in, Dawes in, and Jamal Rush in. He has the best chance at winning.
One out. It is neck and neck here in the final period.
As Iowa will keep their superstar big man, Dylan Owens, in the game, who has not shown off his paint dominance ability scoring the ball, but he has shown his Kevin Love Minnesota type rebound. And he has, if he doesn't score here, man, he does not. He's passing. Oh my goodness, what is he doing? He had the little man. All you had to do is his turn.
Fourth quarter
and he doesn't shoot. He's been way too passive.
Here's Rush.
As Rush fade away to make it a two-point game. If Rush can have a nice fourth quarter, he's definitely going to win the matchup. And really, whoever wins is probably going to win the matchup. Whoever team wins. As Owen sets a moving stream, to be honest, as Rush now gets the rebound. Pushy, look how fast he is. Gets the rebound and already gets the half court. About a second. Bad alley-oop! But it's Rush! Ties the game! Rush ties the game. Wow. You know, sometimes some guys are just passive with the ball. But the tendencies are right. Trust me. Look at that. Off the backboard, dunks it in. When are you going to see that?
This is the fight you want to see from your players.
You can't question the desire of these teams.
Yeah, that's his role. This is the Iowa. You're not going to have one guy shooting all the shots. If you know what Iowa's about. They're kind of like Gonzaga.
Here's Bowen. Six to shoot.
He's
there. The
alright, bro. Have you ever heard of Gordon Hayward?
And he was fouled.
And that's a foul, and it looks like Iowa will take the lead. But I will say again, Jamal Rush honestly is winning this matchup now. I mean, just scored 4 points on Owens' head, even though the dunk was kind of lucky, but.
So he hits one of two from the stripe.
If Syracuse wins, I mean, this is a guaranteed win for Jamal Rush because this Syracuse team is not good at all. Now screen, Rush. He looks to take the lead. Another fadeaway over two. That's a bad shot. And now Hutchinson gives it to Dillons, who looked like he was about to do something. Now he's dribbling around the court. On top of the key, he looks to pass. And oh, good pump fake by Bowen. No good. Nearly went in. And now Dawes shoots a bad shot. Owens again, another rebound. You know the rebounding numbers is crazy. He honestly has been playing like Jokic if he just didn't shoot. Licata behind the back. Gives it to Bowen. Screen for Licata. Licata gets the ball with Dawes on him. Owens looking for the ball, but he screens instead. Licata gets open. Good screen by Owens to open up the shot, and they are up by three. Jamal Rush can shoot. Anybody can shoot for Syracuse right now. Everybody's a threat to hit a three. But they don't need a three. They can go for two. As Rush is now getting double teamed. But he doesn't matter. Oh, it doesn't matter. But he could not make it. Good defense by Owens. He tried to split the double team. He did, but Owens was still right there for a good contest. And now Owens has no big man on him, but they don't even look to give him the ball. Rush is clamped down there. You do not want to shoot on Rush. Rush is one of the best defenders. And Iowa could have just ended the game. Instead, hopefully my PlayStation does not crash at this very moment. As there's just 18 seconds left. Can we finish the game, please? Rush, fade away. It's good. Rush, he's trying to be the number one pick. As Iowa gets fouled. What a shot by Rush. Don't disrespect the name Jamal Rush. My goodness. What a shot. That is so over Owens, who was a good defender. He's not great. Rush is great. Let's look back at that. Look at this. No, pump fake goes with the Iowa team standing up. And right in their face, he makes it. But now Iowa needs to hit some free throws.
11 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. And now they decide to foul.
And Dawes will foul and they will go to the line. Lakeda is good with the first free throw. Second free throw for Lakeda. He's a knockdown shooter. And he makes it. Timeout to Syracuse. Again, everybody is a threat to make this three. At this point, yes, you need to go for three. Syracuse doesn't have a timeout. Technically, you could not go for three, but it needs to be a very fast two. As Rush gets the ball, quick shot. No good. And that is game. Syracuse will lose this game versus the much superior Iowa. But Owen showed himself great talent, but just not at scoring. He just did not score. But Rush, in very limited minutes, showed off his talent. And we'll see. Maybe Syracuse can make a miracle run. Maybe they have a chance. Maybe Rush hits a go-ahead three. And they are going to give it to Rush, but it's only a mid-range, and he doesn't even shoot it. Wow, does not shoot it. Wow, that's, wow.
Treated to a win. This one was in the balance right until the final second.
Let's see the stats. This is, I'm interested. How many rebounds is Owen?
This is Brian Anderson saying thanks for watching.
Who?
So long, everyone.
Is that number? That's not even number. I don't know who that is, to be honest. I don't know how he won. If anybody should have won, it would have been Lakeda. Owens had 0 points, but he had 8 rebounds and 3 assists. If he played 30 minutes, he would have had 16 boards and 6 assists. But 0 points. But Rush, my goodness, 14 points, 3 rebounds in only 11 minutes compared to 16. Led his team by far. Shot 50% against the second best big in the nation. There was already a big gap between the best and the second best, but at this point, there's an even bigger gap. Now, let's jump into some blacktop. Rush is not, I mean, if you mean raw as in Amon Ra, really good, I mean, okay, but raw as in not good, you're crazy. I mean, I don't know what more you need to see. I mean, I guess he wasn't that efficient, but I mean, when you're shooting threes, fadeaways, I mean, I don't know what more you want to see. Better score than Zay. I mean, he has a bag, what, like, what? For a center, he doesn't have a bag? You're crazy. He's a center. Oh, bro, you're crazy. He's a center, bro. He's a center doing dribble move. He's dribbling the ball up. He is doing that. Let's do half court. I kind of want to see half court. Let's go to 8. Let's do, like, fast games. Let's do Rocky. Let's do Dylan. And let's do Lazarado. We didn't see I'm dumb. Alright, let's do Jalen. I mean, alright, let's do Ty, I guess. Let's do Lazarado. Let's do Adonis. And let's do Xavion. Let's do Kyren. No bigs, just straight guards. Yeah, honestly, I mean, the NBA players have a better overall, which isn't that surprising. Ball in court. Whoops. Almost forgot. That's right. Xavion versus Adonis, Rocky versus Kyren, and Ty Wallace versus Lazarado. Zay Williams gives it to Rocky Michael Lim, who has a dunk. Oh, over Ty Wallace. Number one pick potential. Look at Rocky Michael Lim. Hold up. Dribble. Oh, that's a standing dunk. He could play shooting guard. He's doing that. My goodness. Now it's Kyren Matthew, the also European prospect who went number one overall and has shocked a lot of people about how good he's really been off rip, because he was kind of looking like a project player, but his skills have translated nicely. Now they're doing a back and forth. Ty Wallace tries to make it up, and there it is. Ty Wallace right over Rocky, who's a good defender, right in his grill. Back and forth has been Rocky and Ty. And oh, block! Block by Ty! And is Adonis! Oh, Adonis. Ruined the clip. But he steals it. Oh, Rocky gets it back. And he passed a good pass to Zay. Okay, a little reset. Now Lazarado with the ball, who can score on his own. He can definitely score on his own. Now Rocky goes with Adonis. Adonis on him. I like the matchup. But he passes it to Zay. Again, Zay's not a shoot first type of guy, so he's going to look for guys like Rocky, especially when he has that talent around him. Ooh, ISO. He's trying to get into the paint with the young rookie. Gets the offensive rebound. I would have shot that up. Now Zay gives it to Rocky. It's really been a two-man game between Rocky's team with Zay. And they're just passing back and forth at this point. Another pass. I mean, man, Zay Williams just wants to get carried. Oh, cuts in. I mean, they want to get Adonis isolated, but they're just not really doing anything with it. As Lazarado, at least he shoots a shot, man. Now Ty Wallace with Lazarado, a good defender on him, gives it to Kyren Matthew, who also has a good defender on him. Rocky's team is filled with good defenders, as Ty Wallace is not that good of one, and Adonis isn't. Honestly, all of them. It's really a good defensive team versus a pretty bad one, or a mid one. Now Adonis in the post, goes into the lane, and he misses another layup, as Rocky is clamping him. Now Xavion goes into the paint. Gives it back to Rocky. That's a good matchup for Rocky. We're going to 8. Now Zay gives it to Rocky. Gives it back to Zay. I mean, screen or something? I mean, man, if you want some offense, get a screen. Gives it back to Rocky. Looking to score. He has a lane. He goes back. Oh! Oh! No! Oh my goodness! In the post, he's doing this with no setup whatsoever. Oh my goodness. Let's get to work. I want to see if they can expose the defense. With no setup. Ty Wallace now gives it to Kyren with Zay on him. Potential number one pick versus number one pick, but now Adonis holds the ball. He's been struggling to start, as Wallace has been decent, but he's been getting cooked on defense. Absolutely cooked. The Raptor star has been very good in the NBA, but now on the blacktop, he's struggling, as finally a screen. But Xavion clamps down. Good shot contest by Xavion. Now Lazarado. Oh, good defense by Kyren. Over Zay. Tough shot. Doesn't hit. tried to catch the defense off guard with a quick shot, does not work. And now, Zay Williams with the ball. Rocky off a screen, doesn't get it. Zay will again give it to his boyfriend, Rocky Michael M. Ty Wallace guarding Rocky. Lazzarato with Adonis on him. Rocky off a screen, gets the ball, gets a running start, spin move! Oh! He's getting cooked! He's getting cooked! And now Wallace. Oh, on Rocky, he doesn't like that. And, ooh, that's an easy shot, and he misses. Now Rocky with the rebound. Dribbles up the court. We're not seeing a lot of threes being shot. I will say that. It's a lot of post shots. Now Rocky, I mean, Rocky is very tall compared to the 6'5 Wallace. They're setting screens for Rocky. It's clear Rocky is the dog of this team. Rocky with another screen, and he does shoot a three. Oh my goodness, he's on fire. He is absolutely carrying his team to victory right now. Wallace now in the paint. Oh, he gets tripped! And it's Rocky Michael Lim cooking Ty Wallace. Wallace has potential to win. If there was Offensive Rookie of the Year award, he would honestly have a good chance to win it. I actually would say he would win it. But he's getting cooked. Just not his day as he goes into the lane. He's in a box. You gotta give it to somebody else. Somebody else besides Wallace, man, at this point. Zay going to the lane. You know he's not going to shoot it over Kyren. He's scared of that matchup. I would be too. I mean, at this point, just give it to Rocky. I mean, he's on fire. Posting up. Dribble move. Dribble, dribble. ISO. Goes back to the top of key. Goes back to fading. Crossover. Ty Wallace playing tough defense now. But Rocky is too big, gets the rebound. Oh, good pump fake. And it is going to be Zay with the layup. It's not game. It's game point, though. Give it to some... give it to Kyren. Give it to Adonis. At this point, just run a two-man game. Kyren with the ball. Adonis comes and get it, but he doesn't give it. Adonis is just sitting in the corner. And he keeps running up, and every time he just throws it to the left. Oh my goodness. Run. Thank you. Screen. Yes. Kyren, what the hell was that? Kyren is not cooking. He just shot. Oh my goodness. No way you just shot that behind the backboard. But Rocky gets it stolen, and my goodness. Adonis' team is struggling. No one is playing good for Adonis. The only one I would say is kind of playing good is Kyren, but he hasn't even done anything. Now Zay kind of open in the corner and doesn't shoot it over Kyren. Lazzarato, Michael Lim, with Wallace. You know they want to shoot it with Rocky. Williams. Oh my good, what a bad pass. And Adonis tries to shoot it, gets blocked. Rocky, they're on their heels. Game! Lazzarato ends the game. His first point of the game is going to be the game winner. Nathan Lazzarato. Ty Wallace with the only points, and that was their first shot of the game. Their first shot of the game was their only make. That is embarrassing. Embarrassing. My goodness, Adonis damn near didn't put up a single stat besides that steal, and then he got it a miss right after. My goodness. Rocky Michael Lim with 6-7-2-1. He just filled up the stat sheet, man. And now Lazzarato 1-2-1 with the game winner. Zay didn't play good, but he didn't play bad. He just kind of gave the ball to Rocky. Lazzarato, same thing, but at least he made the game winner. But, of course, Rocky carried his team to victory. But doesn't matter when you win. Just matters that you win. Doesn't matter how you win. Let's run another 3v3. Let's do 8, just to keep the same score. Oh, I didn't change the thing. I mean, we gotta watch Rocky again, right? I mean, gotta. You know, let's do a little mix. Let's do 8 and Anthony. Let's do Johnson Irving. And then, okay, those are the three: Rocky, 8 and Anthony, John Irving, who's also a very fan favorite. Let's not do Kyrie. Let's do Jalen. Let's do Adonis. And let's do Darnell Patton. Let's ride. So Adonis is with the youngsters, but he is on Rocky's team, so I mean, yeah, let's ride. All right. Oh, wait. If Adonis can't win with Rocky, Adonis might have some drop in minutes, to be honest. I mean, that's embarrassing. It looks like Adonis has some Timbs on. Room of view. Now John Irving, who is amazing at scoring the ball. He's a fan. He kinda can't do anything but score, but man, can he score? As he tries to score on Jalen. Rocky over Jalen. Oh, if he made that would have had the crowd go crazy. Now Jalen Anthony Thompson gives it to Patton, the 3-and-D wing. When is draft day? You know what I mean? A wow. I'll tell you that much, a wow. But, you know, I'm keeping y'all updated, keeping the journey, the draft start. I do want to have a mock draft. I would like that. I have, like, a detailed mock draft by, if not me, made by somebody. Or maybe a collab or something. As Aiden Anthony, the Duke leader. Hits the shot. Alright. I don't think I missed anything. As Patton goes on Adonis. He's too little. And that's 2-0 lead for Jalen Anthony Thompson's team. And now Rocky, tough shot over Aiden Anthony. And now Jalen Anthony Thompson's team with the lead. Spin move on Irving. Goes in the lane! Spin move dunk! Look at that! Need a replay! Let's get another replay, hold on. Cook up Jalen Anthony Thompson, J-A-T. Now, 3-1. Rocky, the number one pick, projected to be the number one pick, is down. Irving for 3, Rocky! Carrying his team. They're trying to lose, they're selling, missing these shots, but Rocky does everything. And Rocky, okay, getting not cooked, but he's getting balled out on by Aiden Anthony, the Duke star. Irving now goes right at JT over his head. Rock him like a baby because he made him look too small. And now Aiden Anthony goes in on Rocky. Oh, Adonis caught in a little screen. But they don't go to him. JAT, he needs the ball back after that. What is he doing? No way, he just dribbled out of bounds. Did you just dribble out of bounds, JAT, man? No way, he is scared. Now it's Adonis. He gives it to Irving. Irving isn't scared, I'll tell you that much. He might be small, but he's not scared of the challenge. Adonis, ooh, nice pass back to Irving. Doesn't go nowhere, though. Now Rocky gets the ball. You love it when Rocky has the ball in his hands. Now on Aiden Anthony, who is a good defender. Ooh, Irving got stripped. Irving is not playing too good tonight, but Rocky saved the ball. Screen Rocky, Irving wide open mid-range, but foul on JT. JT, only way to stop that easy shot is to foul. Now Adonis, mid-range, another foul. They don't call this one though, as he is slow to get up, probably thinking he definitely just got whacked. Now JT gives it to Patton. Patton, ooh, nearly goes out himself. Rocky clamps, and a tough rebound too. Now Adonis goes in on Aiden. Ooh, good pump fake, but he doesn't. I thought he was going to spin back and fade, but okay, they think Adonis can cook. Adonis did nothing last game. He was actually awful. But now he goes into the lane. This man is struggling. And Rocky, a frustration foul as his team is selling him. Now JT with Irving. Good matchup. Doesn't attack it. Now Patton, who is not an off-the-ball player, he's kind of more of a catch-and-shoot scorer, as JT goes into the lane, tough lane, he misses. It was tough, but there was really no contest besides getting bumped. Now Rocky gives it to Irving. I'm not seeing the ISO Irving that we've been seeing. He's really passive right now. Now Adonis goes in. Gives it to Rocky. ISO on Aiden. Anthony spin move, half spin. Gives it back to Irving. Back to Adonis screen. Fade away is no good. Irving is having himself the worst game so far we've ever watched from him. Which is saying something because he's not even playing that bad. But he also has played so good in the other games. Aiden Anthony is cooking Rocky. Usually Rocky's absolutely locked down. You don't want to shoot over him. But Aiden Anthony has made it work. Now Rocky, that's another task too. As he goes into the lane, foul and one. That was absolutely a foul. My goodness, tough shot by Rocky. I actually liked that. Hold on, what was that? That animation was nice. It's like he got his arm held. Ooh. Tough shot over Aiden Anthony, a great defender. Now Patton goes on Adonis. Jalen Anthony Thompson kind of had Patton cutting, didn't take it. Now Patton drives the drive in over Adonis. No good, good defense by Adonis Poe, the Thunder, the infamous Thunder fifth overall pick.
Nice move.
Now to Irving. I would like to see him at least catch a little steam, catch a little momentum. Again, we're going to 8 points as Jalen Anthony Thompson's team is up. And now Adonis with a screen. He's open. Adonis is open for three. Bang! Lead 6-5. Oh, Jalen Anthony Thompson, good pass as he tried to undercut it. JAT, choke job. They can win the game with a two. Adonis, he might shoot it. For Irving, ooh, pump fake over JAT. Game point. Now JT needs his get back, goes in the triple threat, gives it back to Patton, give it to JT, let him get his get back, oh Patton, no, Jalen now, there's no movement, there's no screen, oh Patton drives in, over Adonis, tough shots, that's the matchup I like the least, and they're going at it. At least Aiden Anthony, he's getting guarded by their best defender, but at least he's cooking. Darnell Patton's just cold and he's playing a solid defender. At least give it to JAT, who has been struggling, but he's playing the worst defender. Now Adonis, can he end it? Fade away three! Good! Adonis Poe ends the game! Adonis! 4 game 9-5. The comeback is real. Adonis Poe. His only points came as the last points for his team. 2 for 2 from 3. An all-around effort by the Ringers, especially Rocky and Adonis, as Irving kind of struggled. JAT and Patton were awful. Aiden Anthony carried, but they lose. If you have Aiden Anthony trying to carry you, you know you're probably not going to win versus Rocky Michael Lim. Man, what a game. Adonis has to get back now. But I want to do a 3v3, but a full court. I think that would be a faster pace, more offense, and more momentum. But man, what a game for Adonis. Again, he didn't even play great, but he played great to end the game. So Adonis Poe was like that. Adonis Poe was like that. I could add Tragic Bronson. I'm not gonna lie, he would be fun. You know, let me get one more. Should I get Tragic Bronson? He would be fun, cause he's such like a flashy passer. I would actually. You know what? All right. Let me do it quick. Let me do it quick. Yeah, man, Adonis had his best game, probably his best game, or second best, besides the Christmas Day game. He had his best game we've ever seen from him. Pistons, Tragic Bronson, all the way down here. Tragic Bronson has started, what, only one game? But he played good. I think he got like 10-6 in his one game. You know, maybe that was a fluke, because, you know, he shot 2 for 2. Yeah. But, you know, sometimes you don't question it, just let it ride. Yeah, I mean, to be fair, he not only just gamed it, he literally... he also hit the winning pretty much shot, like, to take the lead, so. Not only did he hit that shot, he also hit the 3 right before that. Back-to-back possessions with a 3, I'm pretty sure. If I'm not mistaken, maybe it wasn't back-to-back, but it was pretty much back-to-back. What team is it? The Timberwolves, yeah, Timberwolves. Milton... Wasn't on me, Adonis, the sharpshooter. I want to say a sharpshooter, more like a. I mean, I would say that's more clutch than a sharpshooter. That was more of a clutch thing. I kind of want to go longer games, but like, bro. Oh wait. I don't want my PS4 to literally crash. So. I think that's everybody. I think that's every, yeah, that's every rookie. Adonis is the microwave. Yeah, I would say so. I mean, I don't see him hitting a lot of threes. If I see him score, it's usually mid, like, layup. So, yeah, I mean, you could say that. I mean, again, you don't see a lot in the NBA, but, you know, maybe you can make yourself a name as the YMCA... Hall of Famer. Let's go to 10. Hopefully, I don't think it should crash. Going to 10. I was almost able to go to 11. So, you know, yeah. He's also a good defender. He has the physical tools to be a good defender. Good physical tools to be a good defender. I wouldn't, you know, I mean, you know, take that as you will. Alright, yeah, I mean, we gotta watch Rocky. He's must watch. Let's do Rush. And then, Let's do Liam Archer. You know, let's get a little more of him. The great ISO scoring big. Let's do Ayuk. Yeah, let's do Ayuk. Ooh, that's going to be... Yeah. Yeah, okay. Let's do Ayuk later because we can't have Ayuk and Rush on the same team. Let's do JT, Ayuk, and a... God, no. All right, let's do a 4v4. Let's do a 4v4. Yeah, I wanted to do a 4v4 anyways. Oh, wait, is it a 4v4? Wait, what? Was it a 4v4 anyways? I don't know. Let's just go to 9 so it doesn't crash. All right, Ayuk. Jalen. Adonis. And then... Oh, the wizard. Okay, I mean lost in so long. Jamal, Rocky. Now let's not do Rocky. Let's do Liam, Rocky, and then let's give us Will McDaniels. So the UCLA. You know what? Nah. Let's do Will. They need a point guard. They need a point. And let's look at Tragic Bronson. He is a very unknown player as we've only seen him once, I think. Once or twice. I mean, I think twice, but like technically like one game, I'm pretty sure. He hasn't played a lot. I mean, there's so many good guards on the Pistons, they did not need a guard. I mean, and he didn't go that high, so. That's what happens when you're an out of shape fat point guard, but he has lost weight. I think he went from 300 pounds to about 250, 245. So about the same weight as Croc, but about like 2 inches shorter. I mean, taller. All right, Will McDaniels now. UCLA Demi. They're still bad. I mean, I'll say in transition, that's when it's gonna go crazy. It should be a lot faster because they're going to get in transition. And, you know, Liam Archer, he is a good scorer, but usually more in an ISO. I don't know about a fadeaway. Fadeaway as JAT drains the tough shot. JAT was getting absolutely cooked, so hopefully he can make up for that before last game. Will McDaniels wide open. Bronson's not a great defender. He's solid, but he's mainly a playmaker, kind of like JAT. Two good playmakers on the same team. With two, you have Jamal Rush and Rocky on the same team. You have the number one and number two projected player on the same team. But you also have the number two rookie. Ooh, Rocky Michael Lim over Ayuk for three. I mean, Rocky is failing to disappoint. Now Ayuk in the corner with a great defender on him. How is this a slow game in full court? I don't understand. It's not even like super slow, it's just... Adonis, shoot that. I mean, you're wide open, man. Oh, Liam Archer not scared to score, but man, he should be scared to shoot. Now Rocky drives in on Adonis. It's looking scary if they make this. Tragic Bronson, can he... Yeah, he made a nice flashy pass to go nowhere. Two reds versus two blues, and the blue team is winning. Man, my goodness. All right, Rocky screen. Jamal Rush the center. Now Adonis, all right, push the pace. Thank you. Give it to Ayuk. Yes, drive in. I mean, oh, tough shot. Ayuk over Jamal Rush. Okay, tough shot. First point for Ayuk's team. Ooh, while Rocky's team is, was looking to take over the game. Now Rocky gives it to Bronson. JT with Liam Archer, who's not a good defender on him. Gives it to Rush, who has a great defender on him, Ayuk. Okay, now JT, crossing over. Oh, Lay sells the clip. Sells the clip. He tried to get a clip, but it's actually his ball again. I don't really know how. I'm pretty sure it went off him. Rocky on Adonis. Tried to baby him, but Adonis is improving his defense. He may not be playing, but he is improving. He's improving. As Adonis drives in. Yeah, Tragic Bronson's only here to get some cardio in. Now, JT locked in the corner with no key. Does he have the key? Does he have the key? He doesn't have the key. Give it back to him. Does he have the key? Does he have the key? Does not have the key. Yep, he doesn't have the key. Key's lost. Rocky screen. Tragic. Bronson. Well, rare shot by Bronson. Great shot, man. And now Ayuk dribbling up the ball. Slows the pace down. Of course. Now Ayuk, great defender on him. Does he have the key? Oh, nah. You know he's locked. With Rocky on him, you know he's locked. You know he's locked. My goodness. Actually, just back and forth in the corner, man. I mean, he's open. That's the thing. He's open. Oh, well, now he's not. Now he's not. Now he's not, but screen. What in the hell was that, man? Oh, crossover rush. Cross on Ayuk. Block by Ayuk. We saw a glimmer of offense, and it is gone. Now Rocky. Again, why does JAT not shoot? I don't understand. You have such a midget on you. It's like he wants to do it, and then he just passes. And Rocky, why don't you ISO? Bronson, I understand. You're not like Bronson. If you think JAT is pass first, Bronson is pass only. Unless he has literally a wide open lane. He's like Rudy Gobert. Instead of defense, he has passing. But he actually scores as I say that. Nice shot, and now they are up 4-2. Liam Archer, who is usually a ball hog on his Texas team, is looking like a ball hog as Jalen Anthony Thompson blocks him off the backboard. And now Rocky Michael Lynn with a big man on him, Jamal Rush, with no big on him. No big is on him. No big is on him. Now Bronson gives it to JAT. Now Rush scans the floor. I think he does not realize he has a 6-foot midget on him. Maybe he'll realize in a little bit. As JAT does not give him a chance to realize, but he doesn't need to realize as it is 5-2. It is a dominating game so far. I mean, maybe putting the number one projected pick and number two on the same team is OP, but you're playing an NBA superstar and a NBA bust after the first 25 games. But maybe he will improve after his great Christmas Day game. But after that, yeah, I won't spoil. Now Adonis with the screen. Good defender on him. Fade away. No good, but Ayuk is there to pick up Adonis' garbage. 3-5. Now JAT with Liam on him. Again, like, it's such a good matchup. And JAT is consistently getting these small guards who can't play defense on him, and he just doesn't do anything. Maybe because he's so used to being carried by Victor Wembanyama with the screens and the pick and roll. There's no pick and roll to save you now. As JAT, does he have the key? No. Rocky trying to ISO. ISO on Adonis. And JAT runs in the way, but now Rocky is getting clamped by Adonis. Adonis is playing great defense. I'm not blaming JT for not that I blame anything. I'm just saying. I don't even know what I said. Oh, Wait, what? Oh, because he's not shooting. Yeah. Because he's the only one with a actually blatant great matchup. Literally the only one. At least you can say the other ones, you know, they have solid D. Like, you have a guy who can't play defense to save his life. Now, Adonis, tough shot by Ayuk to pick up his garbage. And wait, he literally just shot. Man. Hey, man, tell me you're delusional without telling me you're delusional. Now, Rocky gives it to Bronson. At least cut or something, man. What we could do is a all-star game of the college and NBA players. We could do that. My goodness. Wow. Rocky goes into the paint. Adonis. Oh, crossover back. But Adonis is just locking him up. Offensive rebound Bronson. But Ayuk gets it. Now Archer. Will McDaniels has done nothing. I'll say that much. Will McDaniels has done nothing. I think after this, I'm going to do a 2v2. Yeah. Adonis is playing his best defense I've ever seen. I'll say that much. So, such good defense, I'm actually, like, you know what I mean, paying attention to it. How much of a box Rocky's in. Rare game. Hard to guard Rocky Michael Lim. JT half spin with the little man on him. Gives it to Bronson. I mean, it's hard to get any assists when nobody's moving. I mean, look at this. I mean, like, what are you supposed to do? Yeah, I think a 2v2 would be good. Cause there's no way a 2v2 would actually, like, not do anything. Man. I'm not gonna lie. My PlayStation shuts off, is it? You know what I mean? It's wraps. Oh, Bronson! Oh, yeah, Bronson's playing good. He's not even a scorer, and he's scoring. Like, it's a good defender, right? Yeah, over Will McDaniels, a good defender. You know what we could do? UCLA. We could do Rocky and Adonis versus the UCLA backcourt. Or we could do the UCLA backcourt and then two other people. I don't even want to do a COD game. But... okay. Ayuk. Can Adonis catch fire now? They need to catch fire. And honestly, if you just run some screen... okay, there, I mean, there's the screen. What a awful shot, but Ayuk! Ayuk! What a shot! How did he make that? What did he even do? What? What? Grabs it, switcheroo over Rocky. Man, what a shot. It's just a 1-point game now. It feels like a blowout by Rocky's team, but it's not. Now Bronson. Again, also, Ayuk is injured right now. This is, I guess this is a hypothetical. I mean, obviously, it's kind of hypothetical. This is a hypothetical matchup, as Ayuk has a serious leg injury. Oh, Rocky on a... Adonis, he's in jail. He's locked up. Now Adonis getting not double. That's actually his teammate right on his hit. Right on him. Yeah, shot. Yeah, that's another thing. Shot clock. If I could lower that, I would lower that. I don't think I can though. That's why they hold the ball so long. It was like, I would actually lower it. That would fix the problem. That would actually fix the problem. If I can not do. Ayuk screen. Liam Archer. No, my goodness. I mean, if we're just being honest, Ayuk's team is selling. I mean, Ayuk is the only one doing anything. Everybody knows Will McDaniels hasn't done nothing. Adonis has been great defensively, nothing offense. And then Liam Archer has been ass. Ayuk has done everything. He has like 5 offensive rebounds. I mean, it's crazy. Just in the game at this point. Or at 8. Oh, JT! Game point, JT! Nothing but net. I bet you don't. I mean, I bet you want to end the game now at 8. We not doing that, buddy. Now Adonis with Rocky Arm. Shoot it! He's scared of the Rockmaster. Now Ayuk. Gives it to Archer. Jab step. I mean, if you miss right here, it's probably game. You gotta shoot a good shot. As Adonis doesn't shoot a good shot. Doesn't matter. Over Rocky, that's usually never a good shot, but he made it a good shot. Just jumps right over him. Shoots right over him. Now Rush. Gives it to Rocky. Adonis. Game on the line. Now, is Rocky going to give it back? Yep, give it back to Tragic. 14 seconds left. Game point. They're just upping the tension. Give it to Rocky. ISO. ISO. No. Who's going to shoot it? 4, 3, 2, Rush. No good. Take over Ayuk. In transition. He's running down the court. Drives in, step back, cuts back, goes into paint. Sell with takeover. Sell now Bronson, and they're gonna slow down the pace after the pace got sped up for a millisecond. Now Bronson gives it to JT. I mean, he could shoot that right there and drive. And look at the space. Look at the space. Look at the space. Just hit the three like last time. Hit the three. I mean, now he's getting closer into the mid-range area. Now he's not even at the three. Rocky screen. Bronson, the playmaking maestro who doesn't get any minutes. Over Will. Game. Bronson carries to win. Who would expect the pass-first point guard to carry his team to victory? 3 points, two rebounds, and the game winner. Jamal Rush was in jail, and so was Rocky. Ayuk, 4 points, 7 rebounds, 4 of 5 shooting, 2 dunks, 3 offensive rebounds, while Liam and Will had 0. They shot 0 for 6, while the rest of his team shot 2 for 12. That's a carry job if I've ever seen one. 2 for 12? 2 for 12, man. 2 for 12. 2 for 12 besides Ayuk. Man, I feel bad for him. I feel bad for anybody. I think Adonis is 0-3, right? Or no. No, I think... Wait. No. Yeah, never mind. He won the game. Never mind. He's 1-2, though. 1-2 is scary. Yeah, maybe that game was a fluke, but his defense is not, though. I'll say that. His defense is nice, but man, he cannot. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do a 1v1. Let's do a 1v1. Let's do a 1v1. Let's settle the debate. Let's settle the debate. I mean, yeah, let's do JT. JT versus Adonis. Game 2. Let's go to 11. Again, hopefully it doesn't crash, but this should be fast. It's 1v1, they're going to be shooting really quick. Alright, JT versus Adonis. Let's ride. Alright, let me go to the restroom. Oh, wait. Never mind, I can't, because, yeah, let me do that. Alright. Hi there.
Check it.
Okay, it's 1-1, and JAT scores. So, obviously, JAT is winning. I don't know what I missed, though. Probably not much, right? Wait, Cliff? 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 What happened? No way, bro, got dunked on, right? So, he made... Okay, that's a nice putback. What happened, though? Let's see. Oh, wow. Wow. Come on, Adonis. You're supposed to be the defensive maestro, bro. Now Adonis into the lane. Tough shot. No good. Now it's JAT going on the wannabe lockdown. Maybe he is a lock. Now JAT bodies him. Bodied.
Oh, with the cross. What a move.
Miss that. All right. Adonis. Oh, block. Block by JT. Block. It's to 11. Block. JT. Body. Ooh. Now Adonis. Looking for something open. Going in. Spin move. Oh, he hit the bottom of the rim. He hit the bottom of the rim. He sucks. Get his ass off the court. Oh, brother. This guy's ass. Oh, my goodness. Go back to the G League. Now Adonis. Cross. Ooh, spin. Goes into lane. Pump. He's trying everything. No good. He's in jail. Now JT. Oh, broke his ankles. Oh, what? No way. No. He's getting bullied. Oh. And he faded. Oh. No.
Yo, come on, man. We came to see some buckets.
Now Adonis trying to get his get back. Oh my goodness. Adonis now, he is in jail. I mean, JT's a solid defender. He's not even that good, though, but he is absolutely boxing Adonis, who was supposed to be a crafty scorer. And, oh, they call a foul? They called a foul on that. Now, oh, good post work. He's cold, but he gets the layup. Yeah, I would say that. The only thing he's really doing is getting offensive rebounds. And now, JAT posting up. How is he bodying him? But he misses. Tough shot. But he is really getting... some good body work by bodying Adonis. Pause. Adonis fade! It's not over yet. Adonis making a run. Now JT down the lane. Bad shot, but he just ran. He just trucked Adonis out of bounds. So he's going to get his own rebound. Now Adonis driving in. Spin move. Spin back off the sideline. Now Adonis, ooh, cross, size up, ISO, I mean obviously, but ISO, lay is good, he is not going away easy, JT, ooh, tough shots, no good, rebound, offensive rebound, he's getting bullied in the paint, he's getting bullied on the boards, Adonis now. Another post shot is no good. I didn't know he was a post hook specialist. Now that he's playing a 1v1, he's doing nothing but post hooks. He's scared of the shot. Another rebound. The 6'7" small forward is getting bodied by the 6'5" shooting guard. Oh, he got the ball ripped. Ripped. Lay. Takeover. He's getting cooked. He's scared to even dribble now. Now he's got his shoulder protecting the ball for dear life. Missed the post hook. Takeover now. Gotta be careful now. JT might just break your ankles again. Posting up though. And now, fade. Not fade, but little hook. Or not even, I don't even know what that was. Push shot. Adonis again posting up. I mean, he has the height advantage, but he's not making the shots as he misses again and gets his rebound though. And he misses. Man, if he doesn't get an offensive rebound leading to an open layup, he is fried. And no one's shooting though, I'll say that much. I mean, it's not that surprising. You want to shoot a layup in a 1v1. I mean, it's hard to get open for a 3 though, that's the thing. Ooh, tough midi! Adonis, tough mid-range. Okay, I mean, it's not over. He just needs some stops, and he's playing good defense. Good defense! Block! On rebound! Miss! But they both have takeover now. JAT, you gotta be careful now. You don't want to play too risky. Oh! Babe! Game point! Game point! Adonis drives in. Tough midi! He's got the mid-range game on lock. Now JAT immediately drives. Dunk! 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 Game! Game! Oh! 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 How do those nuts taste? How do those nuts taste? Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! 6 for 19! 6 for 19! He got completely outclassed. Should we go to 3? Or is that game? Is that series? Is that a series? Or do we go best of 3? Man, he got fried. My goodness. I've never seen series. Okay. Yeah. Croc hasn't said a word ever since he got dunked on. Go to 3. Oh, because you're probably about to leave. And I'm not going to 3. I'm not going to 3, bro. Oh, you're saying that's got to be serious. Wait, JT? Wait, what did JT just do? I literally didn't see. He literally scored in 10 milliseconds. Wow, tough shot on your dome. But Darnus was cooking. Oh, pump fake. Why do you? Oh, pump back dunk poster. It's a poster. Put back your own dunk, okay. Ooh. Oh, now JT right back. Oh, okay, they're scoring very quick. Now Adonis toilet roll. And now JT. He could end the series right now. Just win this game. I think he's going to look for a fadeaway. He does. In and out. Adonis gets the rebound barely. If you're Adonis, you want to take the lead by all costs. Because if you have to play from behind again, it's going to get ugly. You don't want JT with confidence. But he is getting clamped. Now JT dribbling right into him. Fade. Yep, fade. make. He's not going for layups no more. He's going for straight fadeaways. And now Adonis drives right into him quick. He needs to do that more. If he goes quick cut and then bumps into him, it's pretty much cash every time. But JT does the same thing quick and is good. One shot after another, back and forth. Now Adonis quick, goes in, lost the ball. JT too fast, too furious. And now JT drives in, lay, no good. But Poe is too big. Now Adonis looking for maybe a hook, which I don't like that. No, he does a step back fade. Step back fade, he's getting in his bag. I didn't know he had that. But JT, good defense by Adonis, rebound. Oh, he can take a lead right now. He can take a lead. But he's gonna look to tie, I think. He's going around the three-point line. Oh, you gotta fade. You have to fade that. You can't keep doing that. No, JT fade. Oh, missed it. He's been on fire with the fadeaways. Adonis. See, this is the thing. You can't wait and try to post up like that. It's not as efficient as trying to run up to him. Wait. Oh, Adonis. Do something. What are you doing? And now he has takeover. You can't fade away at least. Do not do a hook. You're not a big man. Whoa, JT's getting shifty. He's getting shifty, but tough defense. No foul. Surprising. Again, threes are going to be hard unless, you know, he somehow get an ankle breaker. Oh, whoa. Oh, ooh, 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 ooh. Oh, spin. Spin back. Oh, tie game. That's sauce. That is straight sauce. That is, look, spin back, ooh, left hand, oh, JT quick, but no, it's not gonna work. Now Adonis can take the lead. Adonis, ooh, behind the back, ooh, he lost his dribble, tough shot, is no good. JT is not getting clamped like Adonis is. He's just kind of missing. Oh, step back. Fade. No good. Now Adonis looking again. Like, this is the thing you don't want to do, is just wait and try to post up. That's not his best offense. Oh, he made it though. The hook finally goes in to take the lead. Now, oh. Tough lay, doesn't matter. He tried to use that athleticism. Doesn't matter. Oh, half spin. Adonis. Oh, clamped. Doesn't matter. He's still going. Still has a dribble. Lay. You have to fade. You have to go away from the contact. He's not doing good going at it. Now, JT, if you're going to do a fade, I bet it. Yep, fade away. Ooh, he's missing. He's just choking. He's not getting clamped. He is just choking. Now Adonis, he kind of had a lane, but he's getting clamped. But he gets the rebound. Easy. It's getting scary. It's scary hours now. Because that's a 2-point lead for Adonis Poe. Ooh, tough lay. Tough lay. Tough lay again, but he gets it. 5-6. But Adonis has takeover after his make. Oh, Adonis into the lane. No foul. Offensive rebound. No foul. Let's watch that back. Oh, look. No foul there at any point. Man, the refs got something cooking. Ooh, no foul. Ooh, I mean, that's, it's like it's blocked, but you grabbed his arm. You grabbed his arm, though. Grab his arm, then you block him. You know, it's like a child trying to block his dad. You're jumping on his back. Now JT. And it's JT's ball? And he makes it? What? Wow. Wow, but Adonis doesn't... Ooh, tough shot over your head. But man, that's crazy. His ball? That's crazy. Wow, JT tough shot. Wow. JT's not complaining. He's going to keep riding. Adonis Poe now. Ooh, block into the stands. Don't hit somebody. My goodness. Look, he speeds up. Boom! Boom! Is that his ball? I was gonna say. Oh, Adonis half spin. Again, you have to do that. Oh, cross. But he's clamped. Blocked again! Blocked again! Blocked again! He's in jail. He is in jail. Half spin looking good. And then boom, out of bounds again. Oh, quick shift, blocked again. He's blocked, bounces off his ball. What, 3-3 blocks for JT. Goes in, easy lay. Easy lay. Oh, baby. Adonis clamped. Ball. We're going to 11. We're going to 11. JT. Fade away. Kobe. Kobe. Oh, it's off. Adonis now. You gotta, this momentum is crazy. The momentum is shocking how much it shifted. Oh, Adonis blocked again! Four straight blocks! Four straight blocks! Four straight blocks! Ooh! Four straight blocks! Four straight blocks. Oh, he goes in. Oh, 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 what now? What now? Block this. Ooh, look at this. Look at that. He's looking like LeBron with Wade. Put your hands up. Oh. Ooh, JT. Oh. The fade again in the post. Post move. Adonis. Oh, he goes in. No, he stops on a dime. He can end it. A three ends it. Oh, he tries to go for the steal. No. Cooked. He went for the steal. But he got nothing in return. Miss. Choke. Oh, stop on a dime. On a dime. Game. What now? Game time. Talk that. 8 for 26. 14 for 45. 14 for 45. 14 for 45 in the last two games for him. 14 for 45. Five blocks for Jalen Anthony Thompson. I'm four in a row. And he shot, again, about 50%. I think last time he shot 10 for 19. So 21 for 42, or no, 21 for 41 compared to 14 for 45. I mean, my goodness. is undisputed. No steals, no blocks, nothing. Nothing. Three dunks, though. I would say that. Three dunks for Adonis. I mean, he's a plus four overall because he is better. He is better. So, now, if he beat him, maybe Adonis gets the overall boost. Maybe JT goes down. Maybe JT goes down, but that didn't happen. And Adonis wasn't even in the first game. The first game, that was domination. It wasn't like both games were close. It was domination that first game. And then you got dominated that whole second half of the second game. So. What? How is he a team? I guess he's a team player for sitting his ass on the bench. Besides that, he's not a team player. Exactly. I mean, let's run it. Yeah, okay. I think last game. Let's run a 2v2. Why not? I mean, that doesn't really decide anything, but last game, I want a 2v2. We could do... I feel like I've seen too much of Rocky. I mean, too far, we haven't seen him. That's the game. I do want to see... Let's do full court 2v2. Full court 2v2. Let's go to 11. Full court 2v2. Let's do Rocky... Let's do Rocky, Jalen Anthony Thompson, Adonis Poe, Kyron Matthew. No. Yeah, number one pick and projected number one pick. Yeah, let it ride. Number one overall pick versus number one projected pick, and then let's ride. No excuses, as the overalls are actually in favor of JAT, but it's literally plus one, I think, overall combined. Now, Kyron Matthew, two European stars, number one picks projected. JAT, well, Adonis on, they are matching up. Oh, but screen, oh, Kyron, good cross. Kyron! No! Whoa, buddy. Whoa there. I did not know he had hops like that. Rocky, ooh, ISO. Ooh, ISO. Oh, he's shaking him. Cross, but he's not open. Gives it to Adonis. Oh, he's in jail. But this time he can pass. But he still shoots. Oh, JT! From Kyron Matthew. Now Adonis. He's got the ball and he's protecting the ball from half court. He's that scared of the steal. Now Rocky with Adonis. Good pass. No foul? Whoa, no foul is crazy. No foul is crazy. And now JT. Wow. No foul is crazy. Wow. I thought they called it. Now Adonis. Cross. Adonis. Ooh, up and under. Ooh. Who let him cook? Let's cook again. Look. Ooh. Snatch. Ooh. And an up and under. Like, look at this. Hold on. Look at this. No foul, ref. No, like, he has to elbow him out the way. My lord. Now JT gives it back to Kyren. Cross over Rocky. Now JT. Ooh, between the legs. Ooh, goes the other way. He's cooking. He's cooking. That's just a lie. That's just a lie saying you didn't touch him. But Adonis, cross behind the back. He just can't create separation when he's cutting. But he is when he's crossing over, but he's not confident enough to shoot the contested shot. I think if he did, he could hit that. Oh my goodness, just stop. Give it to Rocky. Give it to Rocky. Give it to Rocky.
Oh man, what you got in that bag?
Thank you. Fade. The screen. What? No foul again. They just aren't calling the foul tonight. Now Kyren drives in. JT sizing up at the free throw line. What? From the free throw line. He just bodied. How is that even possible? He's 6'8" and he's getting dunked on with no momentum. He's just walking up and dunking on him. And Adonis can't even get a layup in. I mean, how is he dunking on him? Rocky gives it, ooh, spin back, but he doesn't even take advantage. But it's because Rocky is not cooking, man. 5-2-1 blowout by Kyren Matthew and his squad. Ooh, cook! What a move on the good defender, Rocky Michael M. Adonis. You know, this is usually where he gets selfish. I wouldn't be surprised. Rocky! It's not over until Rocky says it's over. Now, Matthew sizing up Rocky. Drives in, clamps, pumps, jumps. Now Anthony Thompson with Adonis. Now Adonis is getting aggressive. He's getting aggressive, but they call a foul on him. They don't like it when they do it, but when I do it, it's a problem. Now JT gives it to Kyren. Drives in on Rocky. Block! Rocky! Block! Rocky! But they call a foul on that! What? That actually was not a foul. JT! Gets in the lane. I'm surprised they didn't call a foul on that. Now Kyren goes. And that kind of looked like a foul, honestly. He couldn't play defense, he just pushed them, but he still makes a shot. Now Michael M. Screen, open. I think, oh, he steps back. Oh, in and out. JT pushes the pace. He's got, oh, he's pushing the pace, crazy. He's pushing, what, you don't shoot that. Oh, block to the fifth row. Oh, blocked to the fifth row. Did he wait? Okay, no, he. I thought he broke Adonis. No, it's just a screen. Ooh, Bumbukla. It's 2-11. It is 2-11.
Yo, come on, man. We came to see some buckets.
JT, he shoots. He misses. Give it to Rocky. He does. Nothing. Ooh, a pull. 7-4. It's just a three-point game now. It's just a three-point game now. Give it to Kyren. Cross. He's not too much of an ISO player. He's not an ISO player like that, but neither is JT. Ooh, Cross, but Michael M is. I'll tell you that. Michael M and Adonis are. Ooh, that's a tough shot, but that's a shot he usually makes. Now Kyren goes in. He's just running. He stops. ISO. Kyren. Ooh, tough shot. Ooh! It's the Adonis offense. Whoever Adonis is guarding, shoot the damn ball. Now Michael M. With Adonis cutting, but now he's screening. Michael M. It's going to be a bad shot if he shoots. Adonis pump fake. Oh, he got fouled. Wow. Oh, my goodness. They don't want to see him win. They don't want to see him win. What? He got pushed. He got pushed. Let's see that in real time. He literally got pushed. He got shoved. He literally got shoved. Now JT ISOs. Trying to quiet the doubt. And he does. Tough shot. Now Adonis. They need a score. And a two would be nice. But are twos even possible? Because it's very hard to come by. Bad shot. But he somehow didn't get blocked. But that was definitely not a foul. As Kyren gives it to JT. Game point. Windmill. Windmill. And look at everyone coming to help him. Come celebrate. He doesn't need it. Oh, look at him. Oh, he's celebrating in his face. Now, hold on. Hold up a little bit. Look at that. Celebrating in his face while he's dribbling towards him. Michael M. It's not over until Michael M says it's over. And now Matthew goes in for game. No good. Adonis. Cross. Oh, he missed. And that's game series. Oh, series. Oh, where was Adonis at? He just got out. He just stood there. He took himself out the play. And he just let game happen. Game time. What a little rivalry they have, man.